We're here this afternoon to change the course of history. After decades of division and conflict, we mark the dawn of a new Middle East. Thanks to the great courage of the leaders of these three countries, we take a major stride toward a future in which people of all faiths and backgrounds live together in peace and prosperity. In a few moments, these visionary leaders will sign the first two peace deals between Israel and the Arab state in more than a quarter century. In Israel's entire history, there have previously been only two such agreements. Now we have achieved two in a single month, and there are more to follow.
The President of the United States, the Prime Minister of the State of Israel, His Highness, the Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation of the United Arab Emirates, and the Minister of the Foreign Affairs of the Kingdom of Bahrain, will now sign the Abraham Accords. They will each sign four copies, one in English, one in Hebrew, and two in Arabic.
But of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say, Peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child.
I want to start today by congratulating the people of Israel and the people of the United Arab Emirates. Today is a historic breakthrough and a great day for peace. I also want to congratulate President Trump on this milestone. He worked very hard on this with his team. We worked with Prime Minister Netanyahu and the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Zayed, who really are two visionary leaders who made a big step forward today to really change the region.
And he shall confirm the covenant with many for 1 week, and in the midst of the week he shall cause the sacrifice and the oblation to cease. And for the overspreading of abominations he shall make it desolate, even until the consummation, and that determined shall be poured upon the desolate.
Israel has become the first country to announce a second national lockdown to combat the coronavirus. This comes after a surge in new infections. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said the new lockdown will begin on Friday and last for 3 weeks.
As Israel's outbreak threatened to race out of control, Benjamin Netanyahu announced the unpopular but perhaps unavoidable decision. Today, we decided on a strict lockdown plan for 3 weeks with an option to extend. But as of now, we've decided that the lockdown will last until the end of the holiday. Health ministry executives and hospital managers have warned us that death rates are forcing the application of immediate measures. A part of the medical staff and the hospitals are overwhelmed. Israel has one of the highest per capita infection rates in the world. Over 1,100 people have died. For days, Israelis have been protesting to demand Netanyahu step down for alleged corruption and for bungling the response to the COVID-19 crisis. After the lockdown announcement on Sunday, demonstrators blocked roads at Israel's Ben-Gurion Airport where Netanyahu was due to fly to the U.S. to sign a peace deal to normalize ties with Bahrain.
We have a corrupt prime minister who's been charged with bribery, who refuses to go to court, and instead is going to the United States to divert our attention as if there's some magic peace agreement instead of staying here. It's undermining the entire democracy.
They didn't do their job. The economy is in a catastrophe, and they want to put us in closure. This is mad.
Netanyahu will fly back to Israel after formally signing the agreement with Bahrain on Tuesday. When he returns, the crisis will be waiting for him.
I'm afraid of anything in this world. There's nothing you can throw at me that I haven't already heard. I'm just trying to find a decent melody, a song that I can sing in my own company. I never thought you
jumping for me, it was a fall, it's a long way.